equipment and M&R vs. ROQ to see how we can help you save money and have the best print shop experience that you can have. I've been printing 14 years here and I've made tons of mistakes, especially with equipment. Today we're going to talk about M&R vs. ROQ, the price and the price difference. Let's go. First thing we're going to discuss today is pricing. And I think when you first start a shop, that is the thing you're only looking at, is how much is each machine? How much is each machine? Who's going to finance me? All these questions. And you got to figure out what's going to be best for you. How many colors you should get? How many flashes you should get? All these things are crucial. Most, you know, people start off their shop with an 8-color or a 10-color. Some shot up with a 6-color. Now, obviously, depending on what kind of prints you're doing and how many flashes you need and how many cooldown spaces, I always recommend more colors the better. If you ask my shop manager, he's gonna be like, if it ain't an 18 color, he doesn't even want it here anymore. He's asked me to replace everything with 18 colors just because of the ease of use of having cooldown stations and whatever flashing they need to make the best print. And when you want the best print, having that time of cooling down multiple flashes can get you the best prints, the smoothest prints, especially using different things like, you know, hotheads and things to iron on the shirt to make the prints even better. How do you know when to jump from a manual to an auto? Now, this one is a tough one because I don't even know the right answer. I know for me, I had a manual for like maybe a month, 2 months, and I got an auto just because realistically my print load, it did not make sense and I couldn't employ enough shifts to print what I had to print back then at that time. So manual printing is very different than automatic. I would recommend, honestly, if you're really, really serious about printing, you just buy an automatic and you start and you get your feet wet. Buy a used one, whatever you do and you get your feet wet. That's what I recommend. If you're serious about printing, if you already have a customer list and you're serious about it. If not, buy a manual, a 4-color, learn the process of printing, because it is a very manual intensive, hard thing to do. So when you're looking at pricing, contemplate what's gonna be best for your shop and your current client list needs. So before I bought my first 18 color, I went in and I looked at all my jobs that I had and at what color point they were at. So I went and said, what percentage would I actually, you know, it might print better on an 18 color. So how many jobs are 10 to 12 colors? And I went and looked at my percentage. And when my percentage, what I noticed, it was about 28%. When I noticed 28% of the jobs I printed were at that 10 to 12 color range, I'm like, man, I need to step up and at least get one 18 color in my shop. Right now I have two and I love my 18 colors. Now, when you're looking at brands, my first machine was the Anatol because it was the cheapest you can get to get your foot in the door. I regret it. I recommend ROQ or M&R, and that's what this channel is about. These two brands that are dominating the market in the United States, what's better for you? Now, ROQs are about 20% more than M&R, but ROQ does also come with a 3-year warranty, and that includes parts and labor for anything that happens on them. M&R is a 2-year warranty on parts only. When you're looking at production, you wanna look at speed. What's gonna be faster for you to register? What's gonna be faster for you to print on? Because that matters. And registration speed and printing speed are just as equal. Sometimes people just look at how fast the machine can twirl, and that doesn't matter. It's really how fast you can get around it and register it. And how is the registration gonna hold? How is it gonna keep? That's what matters in printing. So I'm just here as a neutral party, just wanting to help that same 18-year-old kid when I started 14 years ago and teach them how to make right decisions to grow their business. Because we're all here and there's plenty of room in this market for us to all grow. And especially with the way things are going overseas, America's gonna be a manufacturer again. And I'm here to help us manufacture greater and better.